Good evening, folks, and welcome once again to the Hour of the Time. This is the only hour that ever was or ever will be. This is the hour during which you are going to decide your future and thus our collective futures. I am your host, William Cooper. From the headquarters of the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence, in an unprecedented show of brutality and disdain for the law, the Food and Drug Administration has moved with armed SWAT teams in flak jackets carrying machine guns against people, doctors of reputable repute dispensing natural health foods, vitamin supplements, and alternative health measures. Stay tuned, folks. You are not going to believe your ears. All over the United States in the last year and a half, the Food and Drug Administration has been moving against natural food supplements, vitamins, medical doctors who are exploring alternative health measures, people who attempt to treat themselves for illness using herbs. They have infringed upon the very basic privacy and rights of every citizen in this country. It is just one more move toward the police state. And tonight you're going to hear the story of a small clinic in the state of Washington, owned and operated by a reputable physician, well-trained, who had been in business for many, many years and had never had one complaint registered against him by any patient in his entire life. You are going to be outraged. You should have pencil and paper with you at all times during this broadcast so that you can write down the information, so that you can register your protest with the Food and Drug Administration and with the federal government and with your local authorities. Because it can happen at any time in your city, in your town, to your doctor, to your health food store, and yes, folks, even to you. So without further ado, we're going to get into the story of Dr. Wright. This show is to provide you with information to save this nation, save this country, and to make your life better. Tonight, I think you're going to be shocked at what has happened. And this comes from Dr. Julian Whitaker's Health and Healing. We have another one here, letters from listeners. And this one is unsigned, so I don't even know who it's from, but it's a letter sent in to us from a listener of this program about the same thing. And I have made many telephone calls about this, verified every bit of it. It's all true. It happened exactly like I'm going to tell you tonight. And I'm going to give you phone numbers, a couple of addresses, so that you, too, can verify that this has happened just exactly as I'm relating it to you. And then we're going to ask you to do something about it. That's right. We're going to ask you to be responsible and do something about it. Your own government and the personification of the Food and Drug Administration, FDA, is at war with all who espouse the use of any natural product to improve health, and that war has now turned violent. Only weeks after Time, Newsweek, and U.S. News & World Report all featured cover stories on the growing scientific validity of vitamin and mineral supplements and other forms of natural healing, the FDA, in an unbelievable display of vicious overkill, with guns drawn by accompanying cops, raids the offices of an internationally respected physician. His apparent crime? For none has been charged. No charges have been brought against him. Not on the day that he was raided with drawn guns or at any other time before or since. His apparent crime? He was using nutritional supplements with his patients. Folks, if the outlaw activities of the FDA and its most violent of all commissioners, David Kessler, get that name, write it down, David Kessler, are not stopped, you will very likely soon have to smuggle vitamin C in from Canada, or even worse, do without. I'm just using vitamin C as an example. All vitamins and minerals and natural health products. There will be no need for any newsletters on the subject, because everything except dangerous and expensive prescription drugs will be illegal. Illegal. Many of us have been watching the FDA inflict this brand of terror for years. And trust me, dear listeners, you have no idea what your government is doing. But it's time you found out. On May 6, 1992, my birthday, only 10 minutes before the Tahoma Medical Clinic in Kent, Washington was to open for business, nearly two dozen armed police and FDA agents in flak jackets busted down the door and stormed into the clinic with guns drawn. Marge Murphy, receptionist at this clinic for close to 5 years, was suddenly staring at a pistol pointed right in her face. The FDA agent, or King County policeman, screamed, quote, "Get your hands up. Get your hands up where I can see them right now," unquote. If Marge Murphy, out of panic, had tried to dive under the desk, would this man have blown her brains out? The Tahoma Medical Clinic is run by Jonathan Wright, M.D., an internationally respected physician. He received his B.A. degree from Harvard University and his M.D. degree from the University of Michigan. After postgraduate training in general practice and family medicine, he began his medical practice in Kent, Washington, specializing in nutritional approaches to disease. For 10 years, Dr. Wright wrote a monthly column for Prevention Magazine, read by over 6 million people, and his book, Dr. Wright's Guide to Healing and Nutrition, has sold more than 150,000 copies. He has been in the same location in Washington State for roughly 20 years, treated over 10,000 patients from all over the world. And dear listeners, he has never, ever had a complaint of any kind to any government agency. Can your doctor say the same? Patty Hoops has worked for Dr. Wright for 4 years. Shortly after the raid began, she called Dr. Wright's lawyer, George Cody. Cody asked to speak to the FDA agent in charge of the raid. An FDA agent came to the phone, slammed it down, and jerked the cord right out of the wall. He grabbed Patty Hoops by the arm hard enough, according to her, to produce bruises and exclaimed, quote, "No one is calling anyone until we get through here. We're in charge today," unquote. Patty Hoops, has a heart condition and began having cardiac arrhythmias. And to this date, she has not recovered. Jennifer Harrell, a new employee at the clinic, arrived just a few minutes after the raid began. An armed, flak-jacketed officer asked her name and what she did in the clinic. She stated that she would only give her name after she talked to a lawyer. The officer then said, quote, "If you want to be hard-nosed about this, sit your butt down on the sofa right now, and I can arrest you for obstructing justice," unquote. She was well within her rights, and that stormtrooper knew it. The officer accusing Jennifer Harrell of being hard-nosed weighed over 200 pounds, had on a bulletproof vest, and wore a loaded weapon. A gun, pistol. Jennifer Harrell is 19 years old, weighs 110 pounds, and she now has recurring nightmares. Why was this peaceful medical clinic with a staff of about 15, mostly women, terrorized by the FDA? Let me ask that again. Why was this peaceful medical clinic with a staff of about 15, mostly women, terrorized by the FDA? Why, dear listeners, was the door busted down when normal business hours were to begin in only 10 minutes? They could have waited 10 minutes, walked right in the door, and presented whoever greeted them with a warrant. Wasn't done. Why wasn't it done? Because this was intended to be an act of terrorism to scare Dr. Wright's employees away from working for him and to scare Dr. Wright so that he would think twice about resuming his practice. Why were these health professionals herded at gunpoint into a single room and forced to stand in a circle, many crying, some too frightened to utter a sound? Was Jonathan Wright, MD, targeted by the FDA for heavy-duty viciousness terrorism to force him out of business? It is my conclusion that that is exactly what happened, and I will now tell you why. In July 1991, the FDA seized from Dr. Wright roughly 100 bottles of untainted tryptophan. Now, you may have remember hearing something about this on the news. There was a tryptophan scare. Tryptophan is nothing more than an amino acid that has been taken by millions around the globe for various conditions such as sleep disorders and depression. In 1989, there was an outbreak of disease associated with tryptophan, which was quickly identified as a contaminant coming from a single manufacturer in Japan. Let me say this again. In 1989, there was an outbreak of disease associated with tryptophan, which was quickly identified as a contaminant coming from a single manufacturer in Japan. That problem, dear listeners, was resolved. And tryptophan should have been back on the market long ago. Long ago. As it is in the rest of the world. Everywhere, that is, except the United States. But in the United States, it is legal if it is used as an additive to livestock feed, which we then eat. Well, so you don't get confused, let me say it again. As an additive to livestock feed, which the livestock eats, and then we eat the livestock. Do you follow me? However, the FDA has kept tryptophan off the market for close to 3 years for no apparent reason for treatment of human beings. Dr. Wright's tryptophan had been tested at a prestigious medical institution and found to be safe. After the FDA seized it, Dr. Wright filed suit for the FDA to return the tryptophan, and there is the cause of all the trouble that followed. You see, Dr. Wright dared to file suit against the FDA to return the tryptophan. If Dr. Wright wins the suit and forces the FDA to return his untainted tryptophan, the FDA will have trouble explaining its continuing ban. Now, only days after Dr. Wright filed suit against the FDA began an intense investigation of Dr. Wright. The investigation consisted of FDA agent Spencer Morrison and other agents going to the clinic at night and sifting through the trash bins outside the building because he had dared to file suit against the FDA. How dare he do that? During this dumpster inspection, reminds me of Peter Sellers for some reason, out in the middle of the night tripping over boxes and trash cans trying to find some evidence against the super spy from the evil empire. Only this is a dumpster outside of a little medical clinic in Kent, Washington, whose doctor had filed suit against the all-powerful FDA. Something tells me when this story gets out, they're not going to be so all-powerful anymore. If my feeling about how Americans are going to feel about this is right, and I believe that it is, I believe they will be outraged. Outraged, as they should. So during this dumpster inspection, FDA agents found empty vials of B-complex and B12 vitamins from Germany, as well as other nutritional agents, none of which were illegal, and no drugs of any kind, legal or illegal, were found. These were natural nutritional supplements that you probably have in your own home at this very moment. The only thing different about them is that the B12 and B-complex vitamins from Germany are purer than most of the available B-complex and B12 vitamins available in this country. And thus were safer. And are safer. And will continue to be safer. An affidavit prepared by Spencer Morrison led to a warrant signed by Judge John Weinberg authorizing the search and seizure. But was a raid necessary? Was a raid necessary? Armed police officers and FDA agents wearing flak jackets and carrying guns, breaking down doors only 10 minutes before the clinic was to open? Herding innocent employees into a room and surrounding them with gun-toting, vicious stormtroopers? Causing one employee to go into cardiac arrhythmia, from which she has not recovered to this day? Another very young, new employee having recurrent nightmares to this day? All of them terrorized? Was this necessary? Hardly. Of course not. Not necessary at all. If the FDA was concerned about Dr. Wright's German-made nutritional products, they could have walked in and asked. He certainly didn't keep it a secret. the Germans, dear listeners, are the only ones who make a preservative-free B-complex and B12 vitamin for injection. Many of Dr. Wright's patients have allergic reactions to the American products, all of which contain preservatives. Hence, he imports preservative-free, pure, preservative-free nutrients. This vicious, and I mean vicious, raid by FDA agents will forever be known as the Great B Vitamin Bust. And who in the world ever made the FDA a police force? When did the FDA obtain the right to wear flak jackets and carry guns and break down doors? That is a function of law enforcement agencies, isn't it? Public outrage, dear listeners, was swift and uncompromising. On May 11th, the Seattle Post-Intelligencer, the largest newspaper in the northwest of the United States, ran an editorial which read, quote, "If there is any plausible excuse for the Gestapo-like tactics used in a raid on a Kent alternative medicine clinic last week, it had better be forthcoming, and fast. Were armed terrorists believed to be getting vitamin shots in the clinic? Were naturopathic revolutionaries plotting the violent overthrow of the American Medical Association's National Convention? Were crack and methamphetamine laboratories believed to be bubbling away in the back room? No. 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 And no." The Journal American, another prominent newspaper in the area, wrote this, quote, "Pistol-toting agents and the United States Food and Drug Administration team acted like they expected armed opposition from frightened clinic employees. The conduct of the raid was more in keeping with SWAT team for known crack cocaine dealers. An absurd, absurd overkill for the purpose of seizing dietary supplements, patient records, and some clinic equipment." They seized patient records. Could be your records if you live in that area. Unquote. Several months before the raid, FDA agent Victor Meal from Seattle, Washington, posed as a patient under an assumed name and received treatment at the clinic. Victor Meal described the medical treatment he received in the affidavit presented to Judge Weinberg. Meal was carefully evaluated by Dr. Wright, who, not knowing that Meal was lying about his symptoms, lying about his symptoms, lying about his symptoms, outlined a testing and treatment program designed to help him. To help him. He was treated in a professional and competent manner by all those who attended him, including Patty Hoops, who performed allergy testing on Agent Meal, and Marge Murphy and Jennifer Harrell, who rendered him service each time he came to the offices. He knew that they were employees. He knew that none of them carried guns. He knew that there were no weapons in the clinic. He knew all of these things, for he had been spying on them for quite some time. One thing should have been obvious to Victor Meal. This was an established medical clinic staffed by trained and licensed health care providers dispensing medical services. No one was armed or engaged in any clandestine activities whatsoever. Victor Meal returned to these offices as part of the pumped-up terrorist group of FBI stormtroopers to terrorize the very people who had tried to help him, leaving many of them with psychological scars which will probably be with them for the rest of their lives. Television news crews flocked to the clinic when word got out that a doctor was being raided by armed FDA agents. Victor Meal was filmed carrying out some of Dr. Wright's equipment. Knowing that he was on film, Victor Meo gives the finger to all who might be watching him engage in public service. Where, dear listeners, does the FDA or any other government agency find such despicable employees? Well, apparently there's a lot of them, because this is nothing new. But for once, the whole nation is going to hear about it, which usually never happens. And if you want to continue to have available vitamins and minerals and other natural, naturopathic health food supplements and natural treatments for whatever ails you, and you should have the right to that, you had better do something about this. You'd better get angry, as I know some of you listening already are. It's another intrusion upon the privacy of every American citizen. It is another step toward the police state. It is another step into the New World Order. This FDA raid was not to halt any criminal activity, but to investigate possible regulatory infractions. Rather than walking into the clinic and asking to see the B vitamins, the FDA went to the King County Police and asked for armed support for a raid. But this time, the raid wasn't going after the cockroaches. The cockroaches were performing the raid. The medical clinic had been in business for close to 20 years and had never been suspected of any criminal activity ever. Had never had any complaints to any government agency whatsoever in its history. However, when asked by the FDA for a dozen or so armed police, Lieutenant Robin Fulton of the King County Police simply said okay without checking the purpose, without looking for charges, without asking any questions. This little gung-ho, first-in-line SS officer for the King County Police simply said okay. And it's a she, probably so eager to be one of the boys, she couldn't wait.
None. Nothing takes it off like Noxema medicated cheese. Take it off. Take it all off. Nothing takes it off like Noxema medicated cheese.
How close do you shake? The more you need Noxema. Noxema medicated cheese.
Oh, I just couldn't help it, folks. Now it's time to talk about my favorite subject. You know, this show is brought to you by the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence. My own intelligence organization, in fact, is the largest and most prestigious civilian intelligence organization in the world. Nobody has one larger, and nobody does it better. Most of the information that you hear on the show and read in our newsletter and see on my videotapes and hear in my lectures comes from my research, combined with the input of our intelligence operatives in this country and all over the world. It's known as the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence, CAGI. And you too could be a member. Send $45, that's your membership fee, $45, to William Cooper, Post Office Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322. That's Post Office Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322.
3322. Or you can just write to us and ask us for more information and what's it all about and what do you get for your $45. Or you can call Stan and talk to him on the phone anytime during normal waking hours at 602-567-6109. That's 602-567-6109. Now, folks, stand by. Don't go anywhere. We're going to take a short break. We will be right back. Welcome back, folks. I'm going to give you a little glimpse into the future here.
Thank you.
Well, you've had time to listen to several episodes of the Hour of the Time so far, folks. What do you think about it? You know, we cannot stay on the air without your help. And the reason I ask you what you think about it is because I firmly believe that this is the best show on radio for those of us who really care about the Constitution, the United States of America, and freedom for the world. In fact, I don't just think it's the best show on the air for those of us who care about those subjects. I think it's the only show on the air for those of us who really care about the Constitution, about freedom, about the ideals and principles upon which this country was founded. Now, if you agree with me, folks, you need to help us stay on the air. You have no conception of what this airtime is costing. And we went ahead on a wing and a prayer, believing that somehow the funds would show up when we needed it. Well, the only way that's going to happen is if you help. Get out your checkbook or get a money order. Make it out to WWCR, not to me, not to the Hour of the Time, not to anyone else, to WWCR. Please reach down in your heart, folks, and pull up as much as you can possibly afford and send it to me at Post Office Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322. That's Post Office Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322. One more time. Post Office Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322. Please make your checks and money orders out to WWCR. Please do not send cash. While you're at it, folks, don't forget, send $45 for your membership to the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence to William Cooper, P.O. Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322.
Hello, amigo. I'm Chiquita Banana, and I've come to say bananas have to ripen in a certain way. And when they're flecked with brown and have a golden hue, bananas taste the best and are the best for you. You can put them in a salad, you can put them in a pie, any way you want to eat them. It's impossible to beat them, but bananas like the climate of the very, very tropical equator. So you should never put bananas in the refrigerator.
A banana
for you must be absolutely sure.
You take them
over
and
let
them
rest.
Incredibly, she apparently never even read the search warrant that listed B12 and B-complex vitamins as major regions for a raid force of close to 24 personnel, most of them armed. And if they're going after B-complex and B12 vitamins, why haven't they raided every health food store in the nation? Because, dear listeners, that's not what it was all about. Dr. Wright had dared to sue the FDA to return untainted, good medical tryptophan back into his possession, which they had seized in 1991. That's why. According to Food and Drug Insider Report, a regularly published newsletter on FDA activities, many of the King County police were disgusted with their participation in this raid. And I think that's baloney. I think they saw all the publicity attended to that raid. I think they read the newspaper a couple of times. And I think now all they're doing is CYA. You know what that means? They're just covering their own ass. Period. They were really disgusted. They should have been disgusted before or during, not after. None of them were disgusted while they were mistreating these people. None of them were disgusted when they finally found what was being taken out and what it was all about at the end of the raid. They were only disgusted after the public became outraged at them. Dr. Wright and others contend that the raid was part of the war the FDA has with all individuals who espouse the use of nutritional supplements or any other alternative therapies. Indeed, an FDA staffer told the Food and Drug Insider Report, quote, "There is a definite bias against alternative medicine within FDA. It would not matter how much scientific evidence accumulated. We will just not recognize the credibility of this field of medicine. The historical bias continues and cannot be overcome. When FDA is accused of being unfair to alternative medicine providers, it's true," unquote. And there you have it. Not only did the FDA needlessly endanger lives, a nurse could have been shot and killed, but they confiscated virtually everything in Dr. Wright's office. The search warrant only said B-complex and vitamin B12. Yet they took everything in Dr. Wright's office against the Constitution. That is unconstitutional. The warrant must specifically state the exact area to be searched and the exact items to be seized. And they are forbidden by the Constitution to seize anything else or search anything else. Not only that, but the Constitution clearly states that citizens will be given just compensation for all property confiscated. It's right there in the Constitution. And you people don't believe that you're losing your constitutional protections? You're losing them every day on a daily basis. And you'd better wake up before they're all gone. Before you look down at your ankle and find a chain fastened to it. Before you are thrown out of the bed in the middle of the night and find yourself looking down the barrel of a .357 Magnum pointed right between your eyes. Because if it can happen to Dr. Wright, or Joe Smith, or Lillian Thompson, or any of the others, tens of thousands that it is happening to across this country who are innocent, law-abiding citizens, it can and will eventually happen to you. Can't happen in America, you say? I say you better wake up and smell the coffee, my friend. It took 15 hours for the FDA agents to pack up Dr. Wright's career, that's right, I said career, and disappear into the night. They didn't arrest anyone. They didn't charge anyone with any crime. They took patient files, Rolodexes, computer equipment, accounts receivable, accounts payable, books, audio tapes, laboratory equipment, laboratory supplies, virtually everything that was not nailed to the building, including $50 worth of postage stamps, which I will bet my grandmother's panties has already been used to mail their personal mail.
Since the raid last May, no charges have been filed against Dr. Wright, and none of his property has been returned.
Even if the FDA trumps up some garbage, regulatory violations against Dr. Wright, no charges will be brought against his staff. However, these women were imprisoned inside the clinic, humiliated and terrorized by the FDA gang of hoodlums. They could not even go to the bathroom without some FDA agent or stormtrooper Kent County Police consent. Roger Lowell, the district director of the FDA on the West Coast, confirmed to me on the phone that once the FDA seizes property, they keep it. Even if no charges are filed, that is against the Constitution, it's against the law, it's against all the precepts that this nation is founded upon, it is against everything that every American believes in. It's wrong, just flat wrong. Moving on. Most people are so afraid, though, so terrorized, so scared, that they never challenge it, never file suit, never go against the all-powerful FDA. Suits against the FDA for return of seized property are very rare because people are scared. When you seize an entire business, ladies and gentlemen, dear listeners, when you seize an entire business, the business disappears. The FDA is then off to investigate another suspicious business with its search and seizure methods. I have no doubt that the viciousness of this raid was ordered by FDA Commissioner David Kessler. It's typical of his get tough, send a message policies. Sorry, folks, but I just can't put an MD after the name of a man who is determined to destroy all forms of nutritional medicine and who sends armed troops to terrorize receptionists, nurses, and patients. I just can't do it. And who does he work for? Remember that both Dan Quayle and George Bush have had heavy financial ties to Lilly Pharmaceutical Corporation. Remember that. Things are out of control and have been for some time now. The lawless, mean-spirited FDA and other agencies of the government has been running around seizing businesses at gunpoint for years. It is destroying the possibility for reasonable health care in this country. And it's not so that doctors can get rich, folks. It's because they want as many people to die by the year 2000 as they possibly can get to die as a part of the global 2000 population control plan that was submitted to President Carter and signed by President Carter during his administration. Please do something. Voice your opinion. Call your congressman. Call the FDA. Fax your outrage to the White House. Send it in the mail. Do all of these things. Remember, letters to politicians are weighed, not read, so be brief. But please, do be counted, perhaps with just a few questions. Such as, and you don't have to write this, but something like this. Dear President Bush, why were guns used to raid a doctor's office on suspicion of using B vitamin and Dr. Wright's property confiscated by the FDA? When is he going to get it back, including the postage stamps? Also, a Jonathan Wright Legal Defense Fund has been established. Please send donations to the Defense Fund in any amount, even $1. Now, you can surely afford a dollar, okay? I don't get anything from this. I just believe that this is wrong, and we have to do something about it, or it's going to happen to us. You all know that's true. Jonathan Wright Legal Defense Fund. P.O. Box 368, Post Office Box 368, Tacoma, Washington, 98401. That's 98401 is the zip code. That's P.O. Box 368, Tacoma, Washington, 98401. Call the White House, fax the White House, send a letter to the White House, call the FDA, voice your outrage strongly. Call your congressmen and your senators and demand that this be halted immediately. This is our country. We need to take it back from those who have stolen it from us. What about the poor citizens whose medical records were seized and have never been returned? They can't even get their own medical records. And what is the FDA going to do with those medical records and the sensitive information contained within them? Oh, you didn't think of that, did you? Well, I suspect that it could be turned over to the IRS, the FBI. Who knows what they're going to do, but they have no right to have done it. It's unconstitutional. It is wrong. It's just flat wrong. Period. The FDA certainly never expected the kind of publicity this matter is generating. They would never have selected Dr. Wright if they knew of the media and public's response and this radio broadcast and all of the others. One must understand that this doctor, Dr. Wright, trained at Harvard Medical School and the University of Michigan, has been in practice in Washington since 1970 and has treated literally tens of thousands of patients, none of whom have ever complained or died or suffered the ill effects of any of his treatment. The nearest pharmacy to Dr. Wright's clinic at a different address with no financial connection to his clinic was also raided at the same time by the FDA. Unbeknownst to anyone witnessing the Dr. Wright raid. Now get this. The pharmacy owner said that over $100,000 in equipment was removed by the FDA, including freezers, freeze dryers, encapsulation equipment, etc. He has been closed down by the FDA. He's been put out of business also. Why? Why? Because he filled prescriptions written by a licensed medical doctor named Dr. Wright. Every prescription he filled was legal, and he did nothing wrong. And he is understandably very bitter, and so am I. I'm outraged. This is Hitler tactics in the United States of America. This is what used to happen in the Soviet Union that Americans professed to hate so much. Then why are we allowing it? Why are we allowing it? You should call ABC, NBC, and CBS to carry this story on primetime, 60 Minutes, Inside Report, or anybody else that you can think of to send it to. Well, I hope this show has illuminated some of the things that are going on that you are not supposed to know that are going on, that the powers that be do not want you to know are going on. Remember, this program is to educate and inform. And my admonition is don't believe me, don't believe Chuck Harder, don't believe Tom Valentine, don't believe Larry King, Dan Rather, Ted Koppel, George Bush, Bill Carter, or even your own mother, because the deception in the world today is so deep. In order to bring about a one-world totalitarian socialist state that you cannot afford to believe anyone, check it out. Prove me wrong. If you can prove me wrong, call me and tell me, because I want to know about it. I want to correct it if I'm wrong. In the meantime, folks, join CAGI, the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence. It's our intelligence network. It is, in fact, the largest civilian intelligence network in the world and the most successful so far. To join CAGI, send $45 to William Cooper, P.O. Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322. That's P.O. Box 3299, Camp Verde, Arizona, 86322. Or you can just write and ask what it's all about. We'll send you information, complete explanation, all the benefits, everything. Or you can just call Stan at 602-567-6109. That's Stan at 602-567-6109. Stan will talk to you. He'd be happy to send you a list of available materials and send you some information that explains what CAGI is all about. While you're at it, send for my book, Behold a Pale Horse, the only book in the world that's guaranteed. If you don't think it's what you wanted, send it back in new condition and we'll refund your money, no questions asked. $25 for CAGI members, $30 for everyone else, includes postage and handling. If you get it, you don't think it's what you wanted, send it back in new condition and we will refund your money, no questions asked. Tomorrow night is IRS night. Until then, good night and God bless each and every one of you.
Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Pledge of allegiance to the flag and the pledge to the ideals of our forefathers. The men who fought and died in the building of this great nation. It's a pledge to fulfill our duties and obligations as citizens of the United States and to uphold the principles of our Constitution. And last but not least, it's a pledge to maintain the four great freedoms cherished by all Americans. Freedom of speech, freedom of religion, freedom from want, and freedom from fear. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States.